Hi, this is Sean Kelly. Welcome to the second episode of Folked Up Friday. This Folked Up Friday is brought to you by unhappyfranchisee.com and the Let's Stop a Scam initiative at gofundme.com/NYBagelScam. Be sure to visit there, donate what you can, and you can participate in the effort to stop a scam on Craigslist, which is both worthwhile and fun. Speaking of worthwhile and fun, we're happy to have the world-famous Boney Fingers coming to us by a live feed from a windstorm somewhere, and he's going to share with us a work in progress, a song that he's working on right now. He doesn't have it all polished and all finished up, but he's going to share with us this song about Dickey's barbecue and give us a glimpse inside the creative mind of a songwriter of the stature of Boney Fingers. So let's see if we got him. Boney, thanks for joining us today. No problem. What are you going to play for us today?
This one's kind of a follow-up to what Woody Guthrie said about some men rob others with a six-shooter and some of them use a fountain pen. This one is more about how they also can use barbecue tongs and an apron and a big yellow coat.
Sounds great. Let's hear it.
It's called The Night I Burned My Dickies Down.
Virgil Kane is my name, and I was a Dickies franchisee. The Dickies corporate came and demanded all of their fees. Well, I spent all I had to open the store, mortgage my house to borrow some more. I asked for help, Dickies lawyers got mean, sent me the nastiest default letter you've ever seen. Sell it again, but I'll be darned. I torch this pit before another family gets burned. That's why I burn my Dickies down. Franchise directors were screaming, man, I burn my Dickies down. And Dickies lawyers were scheming, they went more, 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 more. All you got, but now we want some more. Now homeless and holding signs, my wife, she says to me, Virgil, quick, come see, there goes the rolling Dickie. Now I don't mind sleeping in the grass, in a box near the Dallas overpass. Sometimes I dream of a fiery pen with both the rolling Dickies turning on a spin. And I burn my Dickies down. Franchise directors were screaming. And I burn my Dickies down. And Dickies lawyers were scheming. They went more, 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 more. Reckoning's coming, owners and employees. This road have you played in the Dickies tragedy? Did you contact unhappy franchisee? Did you share what you knew anonymously? Or did you mind your business, help roll and get rich? Did you help expose that thief? Thank you. were steaming there.